7 on your side. Michael Finney is here answering questions sent to him through Facebook, Twitter, and email. Michael, the first comes from June, who asks, I bought an as-is used vehicle from a dealership. Yeah, within 4 hours, the car overheated. What can I do?
Look, I'm sorry, I've got some bad news, but as-is is just that. If the car was properly marked as not having a warranty or guarantee, if it was, then there really isn't much you can do. The dealership is off the hook, but there are two additional possibilities, and I want you to check them out. Sometimes used cars actually still have a warranty, but the seller doesn't know about it. It's a used car. They don't look it up. They just throw in a sticker that says no warranty. So you need to check that. I found that a bunch of times. And you need to check with the manufacturer to see if the warranty is still there. Second, the overheating may be covered by a recall, so I need you to check that too. I'll post a link where you can check on your car's recall.
All right, Lawrence asks, I made an online purchase, but I never received the shipment. I did pay for the item.
Ouch. Oh, these are tough ones. I've got to tell you, this is the biggest drawback of buying online. Do you know if the item was actually shipped? I want you to ask the online retailer for proof. If it was sent, where was it last seen? The tracking website will tell you that. If the store sent the item, but it disappeared before reaching your home, then you can file a complaint with the package service, UPS, FedEx, whoever. I'll actually help you with that if you call my hotline. However, if the package is tracked to your home and a porch bandit got it, then you're probably just out of luck. You can ask the store for a new item. Sometimes they'll go for it if you bought enough from them.
Okay. Well, Paul asks, I'm pretty new to the city, but am I allowed to park in a street cleaning zone in San Francisco after the street sweeping truck has already gone by, but it's still the street cleaning time frame?
Okay. Now, you may be new here, but you're pretty street smart. Let me tell you. Yes, in San Francisco, once a street sweeping truck has passed by, you're allowed to sneak in and park. So if there's no parking from 8 a.m. till 10 a.m. and the truck makes their trip by, let's say 9, then you can go in after that. They're not allowed to give you a ticket. Now, I'll post a link to the San Francisco Municipal Transportation Agency's website so you can check it out for yourself. By the way, when I lived in the marina, there'd be like a whole set of cars waiting for the truck to go by. Just like scoot right in. Now, if you have a question for me, you can record a 10 to 15 second long question, share it on social media, use hashtag AskFinney. You can also reach me on my Facebook page or through ABC7News.